Hi, I'm Aaron Thomas, and in this video, I'm going to explain why couples who get married later in life should strongly consider getting a prenup. First, couples overall are marrying later in life than their parents did. In the 1960s, the average age for spouses getting married was 21. Today, it's 29. And that 8-year difference makes a big difference when it comes to marital finances. A couple who is 21 is likely fresh out of college or very early in a career. That couple back in the 1960s probably didn't own a house yet, didn't have a 401k account, credit cards had been invented but weren't widely used like they are today, student loan debt wasn't anything like it is today. So spouses that were 21 years old and getting married in the 1960s were really starting their financial lives from scratch. Compare that to a couple getting married today at age 29. Those spouses are very likely to have retirement accounts and savings accounts, even if they're not huge. One or both spouses may own their own home with some equity. They likely have multiple credit cards, multiple checking accounts. They may have tens of thousands of dollars in student loans. And maybe more importantly than all of those things, people already have their own financial habits by their late 20s. At that age, one spouse could be a spender while the other one is a saver, and it's harder to change those habits than if you were 20 years old. Simply put, a couple getting married today has a way more complicated job combining their finances. And that's the default. The default is that the state looks at everything you own as joint property. And for most couples getting married later in life, that's not their reality. Couples don't intend for the other spouse to be liable for the credit cards or student loans they had before they got married. Couples who own a home prior to getting married often don't expect the other spouse to be liable for the expenses on that home, nor do they expect that their new spouse automatically gets an ownership stake in that house. But these things are exactly what happens accidentally every day when couples get married without a prenup. Like I explained in my other video called Yes, You Already Have a Prenup, you either write your own rules for how your finances will be combined or kept separate, or you accept the default rules in your estate. And the default rules don't work for most couples, and certainly not for marrying couples who are approaching age 30 or older. A prenup lets you carefully combine your marital finances and decide for yourself what is going to belong to you, what is going to belong to your spouse, and what will belong to the two of you as a couple. You can decide how you're going to pay for expenses during your marriage and which debts will be which spouse's responsibility. It's not just about planning for divorce. It's about planning how your finances will work during your marriage and avoiding some of the money arguments that lots of couples have. If you're getting married later in life, don't leave the important task of combining your marital finances up to chance. Visit us at georgiaprenups.com to learn more about how you can plan your financial relationship with your spouse the smart way.